Is your job killing you? Do you have a stressful job, long hours, lots of sitting down, taking time away from the family, things stressing you out that are having an impact on your mental health? Your stressful job could actually be doing real damage to your physical well-being as well. Here's four reasons why your job could be killing you. Long commutes. For some people, particularly those in urban areas like New York City, long commutes can mean lots of walking and stair climbing, and that's good for the heart and for your lungs. But the thing is, most of America and most of the world travels by car. And when you pair sitting on your ass in your car in the mornings and then sitting at your desk all day and then sitting on your ass again on the drive home, that can be really bad for your health. A recent study found that people who sit down a lot have lower cardiorespiratory fitness. Or CRF. A decrease in CRF is often correlated with an increase in what's called metabolic risk. A person who's at metabolic risk typically has three or more of the following signs: abdominal fat, high levels of fat in the blood, high blood pressure, and high blood sugar. A study in the Journal of Preventive Medicine concluded that commuting large distances was negatively associated with physical activity. So if you're spending a lot of time on your commute, you often have less time to go to yoga after work. Having poor cardiorespiratory fitness is associated with having a high body mass index, a larger waist circumference, and high blood pressure. None of those things are good. Sick building syndrome. Do you work in a building? You may have sick building syndrome. According to the NHS, which is the UK's equivalent of Medicaid, sick building syndrome describes a range of symptoms thought to be linked to spending time in a certain building, most usually a workplace, but that no specific cause can be found. Speculated causes include recirculated air, indoor toxins, and chemicals from the outdoors. People with sick building syndrome report getting headaches, eye, throat, and nose sensitivity, coughing, itching, nausea, and fatigue. This can often be caused by things as innocent as the tiny little specks of printer dust that come along when someone's printing right next to you. They can be inhaled and they can really damage your lungs and internal organs. Poor posture when sitting. Everyone knows that this is good posture, and it's hard to have good posture when you're sitting like this all day. But is posture really that important? Yes! Good posture uses energy efficiently, the way our bodies are meant to. It takes cues from our center of gravity rather than straining our muscles to keep us upright. Overuse of our muscles doesn't just tire us out, it also grinds and wears down our joints in a way that can actually cause early onset arthritis or degenerative joint disease. Overexposure to printers and photocopiers. Now, we all know that printing is bad for the environment, but did you know that it also might be bad for your health? While this field is still in its infancy, some researchers have shown that laser printing creates a shower of tiny particles which remain in the air and can be inhaled deep into our lungs. Whether these particles are harmful is the subject of ongoing research, good science. However, there's evidence that similar sized particles from other sources might be damaging our heart and lungs, particularly for those who sit close to heavily used laser printers. A 2013 study in the Journal of Neurotoxicity found that nanoparticles from photocopiers can introduce oxidative stress and upper respiratory tract inflammation. Oxidative stress is essentially an imbalance between the production of free radicals and the ability of the body to counteract or detoxify their harmful effects through neutralization by antioxidants. A scientist would say more research is needed, but the initial results don't look good. But what do you guys think? Do you have any ways that we can hack our work environment to make working healthier for us? Do you have a standing desk or any other tricks like that? Let us know in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jade Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching ScIQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.